Welcome all of you in online teaching learning process. We have started paper number 7 in organic chemistry, in which we have seen unit number 1st coordination chemistry, and in our last video we have seen distinguish between double salt and complex salt and about the Werner's theory and postulates of the Werner's theory. And in this video we will see details about the applications of Werner's theory with respect to cobalt amine complexes. So first we highlight Werner's theory. Alfred Werner, in the year of 1893, at the age of 26, discovered coordination theory. For this theory he was awarded by Nobel Prize for Chemistry in the year of 1913. He studied addition of 6 mole of ammonia to aqueous cobalt chloride solution and also studied conductivity properties and precipitation with silver nitrate solution. According to Werner, Alfred Werner suggested in 1893 that metal ions exhibit primary valency and secondary valency. Primary valency are the oxidation number for the metal and which are present in outer sphere or non-ionizable sphere, and secondary valences where the coordination number and which represents coordination number of the central metal ion, that is number of atoms directly bonded to the metal, and secondary valences are non-ionizable sphere or coordination sphere, and secondary valences means inner sphere, that is inner sphere or coordination sphere is called secondary valency, which represents coordination number, and outer sphere, ionizable sphere, represents primary valency, which shows oxidation number. Then in case of cobalt, there are 6 ammonia which is present in inner sphere or coordination sphere or in secondary valency. So coordination number of cobalt is 6, and 3 chloride ions are present in the outer sphere which represents primary valency, so oxidation state of cobalt is +3. So this is about the inner sphere, outer sphere or primary valency and secondary valences. Then applications of Werner's theory. Experimental observations of Werner's theory. In all these coordination compounds, according to Werner, the primary valency or oxidation state of cobalt is +3, while secondary valency or coordination number is 6. When cobalt amines are heated with concentrated hydrochloric acid at 100 degrees Celsius, ammonia is not removed. In all these compounds, ammonias are therefore strongly bonded to the central metal ion. All these compounds are found to differ in their electrical conductivity. All these complexes differ in their reactivity towards silver nitrate, and with these guidelines let us study the individual amines one by one. So there are total 4 amines. First one is a COCl3-6-ammonia, which is represented as CONH3-6Cl thrice. So in this case cobalt is surrounded by 6 ammonias in the secondary valences. So secondary valences shows coordination number and it is a 6 and always fixed, and primary valency fulfilled by 3 Cl minus ions, so oxidation state of cobalt is +3. Then second amine is a COCl thrice 5 ammonia, which is represented as CONH3 5 Cl twice. So secondary valency satisfied by 5 ammonias along with 1 chlorine, so coordination number is always 6, which is fixed, and primary valency satisfied by 2 chloride ions, so oxidation state of cobalt is +2. And third complex COCl thrice 4 ammonia, which is represented as CONH3 4 Cl twice and Cl. Secondary valency satisfied by 4 ammonia atoms and 2 chloride ions, so here coordination number of cobalt is always fixed one, that is 6, and oxidation state that is plus 1, because primary valence is satisfied by only one chlorine atom. And last one, COCl3 ammonia, which is represented as CONH3 thrice Cl thrice. So secondary valence is satisfied by 3 ammonia and 3 chlorine. So coordination number is 6, but in primary valency there is no any ions present, so oxidation state is a 0. On the basis of Werner's coordination theory, different composition of cobalt amine complexes are: first one, COCl thrice 6 ammonia, COCl thrice 5 ammonia, COCl thrice 4 ammonia and COCl thrice 3 ammonia, which are denoted and formulated in above figures. So first complex, COCl thrice 6 ammonia, that is in first diagram we have seen. On treatment with silver nitrate solution, COCl3 6 ammonia immediately gives precipitate of silver chloride ions corresponding to all three chloride ions. Hence all the three chloride ions must be in the ionization sphere and satisfy the primary valency of cobalt. So here oxidation state of cobalt is a plus 3, because three chloride ions will be released or precipitated. So here COCl3 6 ammonia reacted with HNO3, we are getting 3 HCl precipitate. Second property, as ammonia is not removed on treatment with concentrated HCl, it must be strongly bonded to central metal ion cobalt. Hence all the 6 ammonias must be in the coordination sphere of the complex and they must be satisfying secondary valency of cobalt. Then cryoscopic measurement of COCl3 6 ammonia indicate the presence of 4 particles, that is CONH3 3 plus and 3 Cl minus, that is this one particle and these 3 particles, so total 4 particles, and molar conductivity corresponds to 6 charges for the solution of COCl3 6 ammonia in nitrobenzene, that is 3 chloride ions and 3 plus positive ions, so total 6 charges present. From this observation, formulation of COCl3 6 ammonia must be done as CONH3 6 Cl3. The ionization would be then, that is CONH3 6 Cl3 ionized into CONH3 6 3 plus and 3 Cl minus. Thus COCl3 6 ammonia may be pictured as shown in figure 1, that is this is the first figure. Then here solid line represents primary valency of cobalt, while broken line represents secondary valency. Broken line means secondary valency and solid primary valency. Then second complex is COCl3 5 ammonia. From the above discussion, one may predict that COCl3 5 ammonia should be formulated as CONH3 5 Cl Cl2 and represented in as shown in figure B. So according to Werner, it gives precipitate of HCl corresponding to 2 chloride ions, so must be in the primary valency. So here COCl3 5 ammonia reacted with excess Hg plus, we are getting twice HCl. Then all the ammonias are strongly bonded and not removed by heating with HCl. They must be linked to cobalt with strong bonds and must be in the coordination pair or secondary valency. Then there must be 3 ions, that is 3 particles, that is 2 Cl minus and 1 CONH3 5 Cl, so 3 particles and 4 charges, 2 minor charges, 2 plus charges, and this is supported by cryoscopic measurement and molar conductivity data. So according to Werner's second postulate, urea metal satisfy both its valency, but in COCl3 5 ammonia there are only 5 ammonia in secondary valency to satisfy the 3 primary valency and 6 secondary valency. 1 chloride is expected to serve the dual role of satisfying both the primary and secondary valency. The bond between such chloride and cobalt is shown by a combined representation of broken line and solid line. That is a coordination number of the complex is always fixed. So there is a diagram which shows broken line and solid lines for one chlorine atom in case of COCl3 5 ammonia. So here one chloride enters the coordination sphere and remains unprecipitated, because only two chlorine ions will be precipitated. Then third example, COCl raised 4 ammonia. This compound should be formulated as UNH3 4 Cl twice, and one Cl is outside the sphere and to be represented as shown in figure C, where only one chloride is precipitated as AgCl. Two chloride ions satisfy primary valency and secondary valency. On treatment with HCl, ammonia are not removed, hence all four ammonia molecules are strongly bonded to cobalt. So here ionization leads to two ions, one minus one plus, and two particles. And last example, COCl thrice 3 ammonia. This compound should be formulated as CONH3 thrice 3 Cl thrice, where all the three chloride ions are present in the coordination sphere. There is no evolution of ammonia in treatment with HCl, and there is also no precipitation of AgCl on AgNO3. So this complex does not ionize, and which is a neutral one. Then overall properties of cobalt amines. First complex COCl thrice 6 ammonia. Number of Cl minus ions precipitated by AgNO3 3. Number of ions 4, and number of charges 6. And formula is this one. Then second example, COCl thrice 5 ammonia. Number of Cl minus 2. Number of ions 3, and total charges 4. And formula is like this. Third example, COCl thrice 4 ammonia. Number of Cl minus ions 1. Number of ions 2, and total charges also 2. Formula is this one. And last example, COCl thrice 3 ammonia. Number of Cl minus ions, there is a 0. Number of ions only 1. Total charges 0. And formula is like this. So this is about the applications of Werner's theory. So thank you all of you for listening this video.